Framing a shot, man, I tell you, it's impossible. This is Matt, Demon Vision, Ninetail. And a broken zero gravity windscreen. Yeah, I even tried to fix it for the duration of time it took me to get a new one in the mail. Oh. Why did that happen? Makes funny noises when you bend the stuff. Yeah, I just broke a zero gravity windscreen. If you know how much these cost, you're kind of like, ugh! That got broken from a simple wrench tap. Years ago, while doing a service on my master cylinder, I was installing stainless steel lines. This part of my wrench tapped it. Probably about that much force. I will hold this tool loosely in my hand. The force it takes to knock a screwdriver out of your hand, essentially. And that thing just, huge piece of it flew off with little splinters, and I'm kind of like, whoa, what's going on? And literally all it was a kind of the wrench popped up and tapped it. Why'd it do that? Why'd it break so easily on camera? Why? Well, it broke easily on camera because it's cracked already. However, why isn't that breaking? I'm hitting it with a hell of a lot more force. That's a lot of abuse, huh? I guarantee that zero gravity would not have put up with that. And I've actually been waiting for an opportunity to destroy this thing. And the reason it gets destroyed so easily, it's made of acrylic plastic. Garbage. If a bird hits you on the track, your windscreen is gonna go away and into your face. Yeah, it's just bug smudge. There's not a single mark on this thing right now from what I did to it. Proof is in the pudding, kids. It's not breaking. How do I know that's not gonna break? How do I know how much this will put up with? My buddy who used to work at Suzuki turned me on to the idea that polycarbonate plastic, much tougher than acrylic. This windscreen can take a shotgun shell, a double-aught buck, and yeah, it'll have holes in it, but the windscreen will still be in one piece. You do that to that zero gravity down there, you saw what me just hitting it with my fist, and those things are sharp, ripped right through my glove. You saw what me hitting with the tool, hitting it with my hands, doing all that, it broke it up really easily. I'm not applying a lot of force. In fact, I struck the windscreen on the bike even harder because it's actually mounted to something I can hit against. Not just striking something in my own hand, where the fact that I'm holding it in my own hand absorbs some of the energy. Amazing, huh? So, if you have a zero gravity windscreen on your bike, please note that, you know, it don't take much to break one of these. It don't take much to break that. Oh, prove me wrong while you're on camera, why don't you? But case in point, there's a million pieces of this thing all over my floor now. But A simple wrench tap started this mess, and you see how very little abuse is required to, you know, do much else to it. Versus wipe this off. Nothing. It's not even leaving, you know, it's leaving a slight mark on there. But, you know, it's... the same amount of force, you know. The difference is polycarbonate plastic versus acrylic plastic. Now, I'm not saying that all zero gravity windscreens are made of that crappy acrylic stuff, but the dark smoke double bubble ones are. So, if you value your windscreen actually being able to protect you while you're on the track or on the road, don't get a zero gravity. That shit's just gonna go away the second a bird goes through it. Or a rock, or a bolt. On the track, a piece of a bike in a crash, a rock, yeah, something like that, anything. Windscreen's there to save you. Windscreen's there to protect you. It's not there just to divert wind around you. That is a safety device. And I got the factory one right here. This is also made of polycarbonate. I'm not going to beat on it because it's the original, but that's also made of polycarb. That's not going to break either. Not the same way. In fact, I would dare say this one's actually tougher. This is a factory Suzuki touring screen. If you want an SV and you want a tough windscreen, factory touring screen by Suzuki. It's a damn good part. It's very tough. You just saw me beat the hell out of it. That didn't survive, but that did. Now, someone can say, oh, well, we don't know how much force you were applying. This wasn't a scientific test. The old windscreen was already broken. It was broken by the force, by less force than is generated by me dropping my ratchet on the floor. Go drop your ratchet on the floor. Go drop it on your windscreen if you think your windscreen will hack it. I won't drop that, but I'll drop a 17 mm wrench on it. We'll see what happens.